So far, we have focused mainly on reading data, but what happens when we want to write to memory? Here we'll consider a single core system. I'll refer you to an architecture class for shared memory systems, where keeping the caches consistent becomes a challenge. We need to consider both what happens on a hit, when the block we want to write to is already in the cache, and what happens on a miss, when it isn't. On a hit, the most obvious thing to do is to write through to memory. That is, we'll write to the cache, and then also write to the main memory to copy the data and keep the cache and main memory consistent. As long as I don't have to worry about some other entity needing an updated version from memory, however, there's actually no need to write everything this instant. This is the insight behind the write-back policy, which only writes to the cache. After all, that's where we will look first if the same processor tries to read the data or write to it later. Only when the cache block gets evicted sometime later does the data really need to be written to main memory. And then it'll be the whole cache block. This lazy approach can be beneficial when the same cache block is written to many times before eviction. For cache misses, we also have two strategies. The first is write allocate, which first reads the current value in memory into the cache. Then it behaves as though it were a hit, using either of the two hit strategies. Lastly, we have the no write allocate policy, where we just write the data to memory and don't bother with the cache at all. The interactions among these policies can be subtle, particularly when there are multiple cache levels. It is worth pointing out, however, that some of these policies share certain assumptions and are therefore often paired together. The write-back policy is betting that there will be subsequent writes to the same cache block. That's why he is bundling up all the changes he is making for one trip to memory when the block gets evicted. Write allocate is also betting on subsequent writes to the same block. That's why he loads the data up into the cache. On the other hand, write through is betting on the cache block being evicted sooner rather than later. He does his writes to memory up front, so that he can quickly evict the block from the cache later if he has to, not having to worry about any writes to the disk. Similarly, the no write allocate policy is also betting on that same cache block not being used again soon. It doesn't even bring the data into the cache.